Welcome to Charm School. I'm Anna Griffin, and this is our Foliage Dies and Foliage Stickers Made Easy. Now, the Foliage Die Set is a comprehensive library of leaves and branches that I say are a flower's best friend. When you're looking at this set, just see how gorgeous. We're talking about graceful curves, beautiful leaves, cut and embossed dies that give you even shadow layers for your foliage. And when they're cut and put together, just look at our pretty specimen sheet. You can see how each one is different and so easily added to the base of a big bloom, or you know, whatever it is that you have that needs a little more texture, you know, a little more context for whatever you're working with on the front of your card. Now we've also, we're working with our foliage stickers. This is 120 stickers. Well, actually it's more than that. It's, 120 dimensional stickers and 36 die cuts. Now these are so fun because they're actual paintings of leaves and foliage, and you'll see like color like no other in this set, plus even winter looking branches and then gold foil die cuts. So lots to work with, lots of pretty things, and I'm going to, we're going to make two cards, and what's going to be important about that is adding texture. All right, so this is what I meant by context. I'm going to take our pretty metallic paper and our vellum, beautiful vellum. I'm putting two pieces together of the vellum. And what's so fun about working with these dies is that no matter which way you slice it, you know, whatever you want to cut it, however you want to cut it, you end up with such beautiful works of art. And I'm cutting two different pieces, two different types of foliage with these, with the vellum, because I want the two different tones and the colors. And you'll see how beautiful it is when you overlay them. So, run button, magnet mat, face down dies. The best part about cutting through two pieces of vellum is that it's much lighter than cardstock, so it actually will cut through pretty easily. You'll see when we take those away, we end up with the prettiest little metallic. These look like they're ready for Thanksgiving, don't they? And then the beautiful vellum, so pretty. Look at this. I love these more than anything. This looks like it belongs this way. So those beautiful leaves, and see, if you layer them over each other, you get that third color of green. And so adding, this looks as lifelike as it can be out of paper. I think it's so pretty with the bruising of the paper with the embossing, and you end up with a gorgeous little nosegay of what I think, you know, a caterer would call aromatics for a beautiful meal. I'm going to put them on a card. So just look at what we're going to do. We're taking a pretty 5x7 vellum foil layer and then mixing all these beautiful pieces. Just look how this looks like a cornucopia. A harvest, if you will. So every piece of that, those vellum leaves, the metallic leaves, adding a little silver for excitement. And then, of course, you definitely need a sentiment, and that's really complete and gorgeous. And, you know, just marveling at those things, the colors of this, for me, are just fantastic. So I'm going to do one more just because we can, and talk about just the compositions. And I've die cut a bunch of things already. So out of the foil die, the dies cut from foil paper, they're all these, the little branches and then the little leaves. And then they're on the paper because we've desiron them so that we can work with them. But this is the die cut in that foliage sticker set. And these are so pretty because if you wanted to add them to, say, a card that you've already started, so let's just say something like this, and you want to create just that little bit more texture that you would do, I would say if you were doing this as a flower arrangement, that's how this would go, is like you would just take these and nestle them in to your design, create a little bit of a background with them. It's so pretty. And just watch, because these are cut and the stems are so delicate, you can actually bend and manipulate the branches to go in different directions. So it's all up to you of how you want to actually continue and, you know, keep adding. My rule of thumb is to just keep doing things in multiples, to keep adding that texture and dimension until you think that is beautiful in the making.